Charlotte County will likely get the biggest impacts from Hurricane Idalia in our area. They've already had some minor flooding during today's high tide.
Yeah, the streets of downtown Punta Gorda were flooding earlier today at that time. NBC2's Sarah Metz is live in Punta Gorda near Gilchrist Park.
Kelly, Peter, just about an hour ago, just like you mentioned, this entire street, this is Berry Street, it was completely underwater, and now the water level was actually hitting at about round where my top of my boot is. So take a look at these storm drains, because let me tell you, they are working overtime. And these streets are typically known for flooding, especially when we're getting excessive amounts of rain. Something to keep in mind, these are typically brick roads, so they're bumpy, not flat, which means one area could be 1 foot deep. You move slightly, and next thing you know, you're in about 1 inch of water. You can see, you know, just a little bit of ponding and leftover floodwaters that are sitting on the streets still. But like I said, those storm drains, they're working overtime over here. This type of flooding that we saw earlier is just excessive rainwater. I do want to emphasize that, because it's not uncommon to see flooding on these streets when we see a lot of rain, which I do want to mention also, we are very close to Gilchrist Park, which means that Gilchrist Park, we have to watch those wave and, you know, the water that goes over the seawall there, because this area, we're only about, you can see Gilchrist Park down there, we're only about a block away, maybe two blocks away. So once that water starts picking up and the water goes over the seawall, this is another area that you want to watch. So right now, all of this flooding that we had earlier was just from rainwater. But as those conditions worsen throughout the night, or whatever the case may be, this is definitely an area that you're going to want to keep an eye on, just in case, because we did see a lot of flooding just about an hour ago. And like I said, very quickly, the flooding is completely gone, and cars are now able to move down this road freely. But again, if you're going to be on the road, be sure that you're being cautious and you're being careful and keeping an eye out on what's in front of you. We do not suggest driving down flooded roads. We'll continue to track the conditions here in Charlotte County, but we're local today from Berry Street. Sarah Metz, NBC2.